whose photo 51 was the key to unlocking the mystery of the structure of DNA.
Science and everyday life cannot and should not be separated. For me, science gives a partial explanation of life. Insofar as it goes, it's based on fact, experience, and experiment.
Everyday life for Franklin involved indulging her passion for Shakespeare. But more importantly, her lifelong love of climbing mountains.
The sheer beauty of it made me weep. Mer de nuage.
She was not, however, quite so struck by the beauty of the model built by Professor Crick over here and Professor Watson over here.
Very pretty. But how are you going to prove it?
Rosie never suspected that Wilkins had sneaked out her copy of Photo 51 and shown it to me. I rushed back to Cambridge to tell Crick, but we needed her calculations in order to build the model. Once we had these, we were convinced we had our Nobel Prize. No need to mention Rosie, is there?
Quite. Though we should be clear that the beauty and delicacy of Franklin's work on Photo 51 showed that the base pairs, adenine, guanine, and thymine, cytosine, were in the inside of the structure, and not as we previously thought, on the outside.
Her mother testified to the dexterity of Franklin's hands in a quite different way. On visiting her empty laboratory at Birkbeck College, not far from here, shortly after Franklin died very early of cancer, her mother was here to say she was always good at sewing. Her colleagues in Paris simply referred to her as having a golden hand.
One, two, three, four.
Do wop a 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 do wop a
fact, experience, and experiment. Fact, experience, and experiment. Fact,
experience, and experiment.
Fact,
experience, and experiment.
Important, why are you not?
Thank you.
I wonder what Rosie, our dark lady of DNA, would have thought of it all. Pity.
Today, Professor Alan Solomon, who is Professor of Human Genetics at King's London, is undertaking research in two main areas, breast cancer and leukemia.
You will hear her voice explaining her work to you, coupled with the music of Shirley Thompson. It begins, at the beginning, with the now familiar pair of DNA. And it represents the harmonious function of healthy cells. It then progresses to a quartet, which represents the division of cells as they incredibly duplicate exact copies of the DNA.
It's not all good, however. There are dissonant harmonies reflecting struggling random mutations.
Oh! personalized medicine. We can begin to treat patients with drugs according to their own actions. We may no longer have to give drugs that are ineffective in treating
finished yet, girls?
Oh. Well, it will be, but in the meantime, let me tell you that Dr. Claire Sharpe, who is honorary consultant nephrologist at King's, is studying this gene in order to try to find a drug that will repair kidney damage. Composer Lynne Plowman has translated the letters that you've just been listening to into musical notes. Thus, G is G, A is A, T is T, and C is C, and U is F sharp.
Oh!
music's finished. Hopefully, Lynne Plowman will finish the music in time for our performance on October the 22nd at the Fabrication Festival at King's College London, which is free entry, plus a glass of wine. You'll notice a theme in our performance. We hope to, at this performance, present all the pieces in our project so far. At the moment, you're experiencing the one that we're developing at King's College London, which I think you'll probably have picked up by now, about Rosalind Franklin. We also have a project about Maria Rothschild, which is also playing here, and one about Mary Anning, who is a Victorian paleontologist. Currently, we have other projects coming in the next few years. But our performance of the 22nd, on the 22nd of October requires a little more funding to get the composers to finish. So if anyone would like to contribute, do come and talk to me, because I have very large pockets and in fact an extra one inside. So to finish our work in progress of the variations from the Rosalind Franklin so far, we're going to end with something which we felt you might enjoy, as you may have found the science a little too simple up to now. So we thought we'd do some theories of quantum mechanics.
This is ridiculous. Where on earth would DNA and quantum mechanics meet?
Presumably in a very small quantized space.
Next thing you'll be saying is happening in a fourth dimension.
Oh. Well, it kind of is. I mean, Kate Whitley, the composer, and Professor Marie Sakeliadu did meet at King's College London. Professor Sakeliadu is a theoretical physicist and cosmologist. And of course, the space they inhabited together was so small it was difficult to see them. But we can hear them as they translate theory into sound, beginning with string. Matter and forces, describing all particles as vibrating strings. Matter. Different string vibrations represent different particles. Matter.
Splitting or joining of strings would correspond to different particle interactions.
Matter. Strings are either closed or open.
Matter.
Quantum gravity. Space-time is itself quantized.
Composed of elementary discrete bits called the quantum of space.
Consisting of tiny one-dimensional loops.
These tiny quantized loops of gravity fields weave an extremely fine fabric that is the four-dimensional space-time of our physical world.
Oh.
geometry. Every space vibrates at certain frequencies. Hence, one may consider the universe as a vibrating membrane, a tambourine.
Mathematical objects summing up all frequencies of vibrations.